Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Joytech back here again with an interesting app review. What about Adobe Photoshop in your hands? Sounds good, right? Yes, guys, there is an application called Adobe Photoshop Touch, but that is currently discontinued by Adobe. Even it is not available in Google Play Store, it is available in various other app stores. Okay, without further delay, we can see about the app. This is Abin here and welcome back to Joystick Tricks. I come across this application when I search for best mobile photo editors. If you don't have any knowledge in any mobile photo editors and you are familiar with Adobe Photoshop, then this is the best choice for you. Okay, first of all, download and install Adobe Photoshop Touch application from the given link in the description. After the installation, you can see the app logo as the classic Photoshop icon as you are seeing in the screen. Okay, open it and you can see the welcome screen as Photoshop CC19. The application has both portrait and landscape mode, but I prefer landscape mode for better experience. The home screen of the application will look like this with couple of icons and a project list workspace. In the right top corner of the application, you can see the settings icon with couple of options. Under general settings, you can see the product improvement program and presentation mode and etc. By enabling the presentation mode, it will give you a virtual feedback about the touch events. And also you can see the auto recovery option there. And under image import settings, you can set the resolution for your images. I am not going deeply to the settings. Next to the settings icon, you can see the layer icon there. From there, you can do general things like creating folders, duplicating projects, etc. From the bottom of the home screen, you can see an image import icon there, and you can select images from various sources such as photo library, camera, and you can also add blank document. In my case, I am adding blank document to the workspace. Here we go. The workspace looks similar to the Photoshop Windows or Mac. The only difference is the tools are nicely packed into drop down icons. Each tools in the Photoshop Mac or Windows is also available in this tiny version of Photoshop. The common tools are arranged in bottom left corner of the workspace, and the remaining tools are in the top toolbar of the application. And near to the bottom toolbar, you can see the brush option and color and stylus option there. In the bottom right corner, you can see the layer icon there, which you can add layers and control opacity and work with blending options, and press the plus symbol to add more layers. You can duplicate layers there and add empty layer and add photo layer. In my case, I am adding a photo layer there. For adding photo, click to a photo layer and select your photo you want to add. Adjust the photo for your wish and it's good to go. I want to change the background of the photo. For that, first select the body of the person. You can use any selection tool for that. In my case, I am using my favorite tool, that is Quick Selection tool. Select the Quick Selection tool and drag through the area that you want to select, and use Lasso tool for refine your selection. Take your own time and select perfectly for better results. Okay, here we go. I am selected the person. Keep in mind, I am not expert in Photoshop, so there will be some imperfection in my selection. Okay, let's check out the top toolbar. Under the first tool icon, you can see common tools such as copy, paste, transform, inverse selection, etc. In the next icon, you can see the adjustment tools, and next to it, you can see the styles there. In the last toolbar, you can see couple of common tools such as cropping image, image size, and much more. Okay, let's add some blur effect to our image from the effects tool. You can adjust the depth of the blur using that dragging button. Okay, it's perfect. Okay, let's add some extra layers and fill that layer with some colors. For that, first add an empty layer and then we can color it. For adding the color, select the fill tool and select color and fill it. Okay, let's work with blending modes. The layer is normally in normal blending mode, and You can switch to any other blending mode by just clicking the drop down box. Once the work is done, then you need to import your image to your gallery. For that, click done and click save. It will take couple of seconds to render the rays and save your project. After saving, you can see your project in the home screen of the application. Click export button near the import button to export your images to your gallery. Select the format you want to save your image and click OK. That's it, now your image is saved into your gallery. These are some rendering I done using this application. How is it? Place your comments below. So that's it for today's content, and hit the thumbs up button if you like the video, and don't forget to share it with your friends. And subscribe to Joyce Techniques for more technical steps, and stay tuned for the next video. Till then, this is Abhin signing off.